Thank you. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for this virtual reading of Nono Boy, written by Ken Narasaki, based off of the novel by John Okada. The performance will be done with one intermission, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. And without further ado, here is Nono Boy.
Question 27. Are you willing to serve in the armed forces of the United States on combat duty wherever ordered? Question 28. Will you swear unqualified allegiance to the United States of America and faithfully defend the United States from any or all attack by foreign or domestic forces and forswear any form of allegiance or obedience to the Japanese Emperor? Question 27. Are you?
I am Japanese and you are my son.
Question 28, will you?
You, Mr. Judge, you can't make me go in the army because I'm not American, or you wouldn't have plucked me and mine from a life that was good and real and meaningful and fenced me in the desert like they do the Jews in Germany.
Question 27, are you willing to serve?
I can't go, Mr. Judge, because my brother's in the Japanese army, and if I go, I might end up shooting him.
Question 28, will you swear unqualified?
I won't go, Mr. Judge, because if you think we're the same kind of rotten Japanese that dropped the bombs on Pearl Harbor, and I guess you do, or I wouldn't be here having to explain to you why it is that I won't go and protect sons of bitches like you.
Question 27.
Yeah, if you let my parents out of prison, and how about my Oba-san and Oji-san while you're at it?
Question 28.
You are my son.
Question.
You, Mr. Judge, who supposedly represents justice,
question.
Was it just a thing to ruin 100,000 lives and homes and farms and businesses and dreams and hopes?
27.
Because the 100,000s were just 100,000 Japs?
28.
So if we're guilty, what did we do, huh? What did we do?
Forswear, serve unqualified allegiance.
No, 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 no,
is a Jap.
Once upon a time, an old man and his wife found a giant peach floating in the river. They prepared to cut the peach in half when it split open and a baby boy jumped out, saying, "The God of heaven saw how lonely you were, so he sent me to be your son."
King Street Station, Seattle, 1946.
Christ, what the hell am I doing back here? Best thing I could do would be to kill some son of a bitch and head back to prison.
Ichi. Hey, Ichi. Meadow, remember? How the hell? It's been a long time, but not that long. How have you been? What's doing?
Well, that is,
I mean, last time must have been before Pearl Harbor. God, it's been a while, hasn't it? 4 years. Lots of Japs coming back to the coast. Lots of Japs in Seattle. You'll see them around. Japs are funny that way. Gotta have their rice and sake and other Japs. Stupid, I say. Smart ones went to Chicago and New York and lots of places back east, but there's still plenty coming back this way. No? Well, I'll have one. Got the habit of the army. It just got out a while back. Rough time, but I made it. Didn't get out in time to make a quarter, but I'm planning to go back to school. How long you been around?
Just got in. Haven't been home yet.
When'd you get discharged?
I was never in.
Well, no need to look so sour. So you weren't in. So what? It's been in camp all this time?
No. It's been a long time, I know, but I'm really anxious to see the folks.
No-no boy, huh? Rotten no-good bastard. I'll piss on you next time.
The old man and women were very happy and raised the boy to be a fine young man. When he grew up, he told them,
"I'm so grateful for the love and care you've given me."
His mother said, "Of course we did our best for you. It was our duty, just as it will be your duty to care for us someday." A parent's duty is to the child. A child's duty is to his parents. Momotaro told them,
"I will pay you back now by going to fight the demons on Ogre Island and bring back the treasure they stole from our people to make you proud of me."
And so the couple decided to let him go.
Taro, wow, you got big.
And you got out.
Yeah, hey, how you been?
Better than you.
Yeah? Yeah, probably so. You about through with school?
Next June.
What then, college?
Army.
Ichiro? Oh, Taro, come back! Yeah, Ichiro, you come home. How good to have you come home. Come, come.
Hi, Pa. Where's Ma?
Mom's gone to the bakery.
What for?
Bread. Bread for the store.
Don't they deliver?
Yeah, they deliver.
What the hell's she doing at the bakery then?
Oh, it's good business, Ichiro. The truck comes in the morning. We take enough for the morning business. For the afternoon, we get soft, fresh bread. Mama goes to the bakery.
What bakery?
Wonder Bread.
On 19th?
Yeah.
How much do you make on the bread?
Oh, let's see. 3-4 cents. Depends.
How many loaves does Ma get?
10 or 12. Depends.
The bus, how much is it?
Oh, let's see, 15 cents for one time. Tokens are 2 for 25 cents.
Christ, Pa, what else do you give away?
Huh?
Figure it out. Say you make 35 cents on 10 loaves. You take the bus up and back, that's 25 cents shot. That leaves 10 cents. What are you running a business for? Your health?
Mama walks.
Pa, sit down.
Yeah, Ichiro. I forget you come home from such a long time gone. We should talk.
Sorry, Pa. I'm a little on edge.
Yeah, Ichiro, I understand. Was it hard?
No, it was fun.
You sorry you said no?
I'm okay, Pa. It's finished. Done and finished. No use talking about it.
True. It's done. There's no use to talk. Mama! Ichiro's here!
Papa, put the braid away! Ichiro, you are back. I'm happy that you are back. I am proud to call you my son.
I've been talking with Pa.
After a while, you and I, Ichiro, my son, we will talk also. Papa!
Doesn't like my not being in the store when she's out. I tell her the bell tinkles, but she doesn't understand.
Hell's bells, Pa. Why do you let her push you around like that?
She's Mama.
God.
Ichiro. Okay. You rest. It's okay.
What I expect. That things would be different. Just because the world went crazy doesn't mean anything changed.
Momotaro's parents were so proud of Momotaro for wanting to help their people. They gave him a sword and armor and fixed him a good lunch of millet dumplings and made him promise that he would come back soon.
Taro grabs a cigarette out of Ichido's pack, tosses the pack at Ichido's sleeping face.
Time to wake up.
Taro, wait. About the army.
What about it?
You could get in a year or two before the draft. I read somewhere that you can take an exam now and then get a deferment if your showing is good enough. A fellow's got to have all the education he can get.
I don't want an education. I want in.
Mano?
Who cares?
She won't like it.
Doesn't matter.
Why so strong about the army? Can't you wait? They'll get you soon enough.
Not soon enough for me.
Why? Why? Is it because of me? What I did?
What did you do?
Don't mind him. He's never home except to eat and sleep.
When does he study?
He doesn't.
Why don't you do something about it?
I tell him. Mama tells him. Makes no difference. It's the war. The war and the camp life made all the kids as wild as stray cats.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Watch the store. Come, Ichiro. We must go and see the Kumasakas. They will wish to know that you are back.
Ma, I don't want to see the Kumasakas. Let's go some other night.
You must go back to school.
I don't feel like much going to school.
What will you do?
I don't know.
With an education, your opportunities in Japan will be unlimited. You must go and complete your studies.
Ma, I'm not going to Japan. Nobody's going to Japan. The war is over. Japan lost.
You believe that?
Yes, I believe it. I know it. Do you see the great Japanese army walking down the streets?
The boat is coming and we must be ready.
The boat?
Yes.
What does it say?
To you who are loyal and honorable Japanese, The victorious Japanese government is presently making preparations to send ships which will return to Japan those residents in foreign countries who have steadfastly maintained their faith and loyalty to our emperor. The Japanese government regrets that the responsibilities arising from victory compels them to delay the sending of the vessels and ask that you ignore the propaganda about the fictitious Allied victory. The day of glory is close at hand. Hold your head high and make ready for the journey, for the ships are coming.
Who wrote that?
A friend in Brazil. We are not alone.
We are alone. This whole thing is crazy. You're crazy. I'm crazy. We made a mistake. Let's admit it.
There's been no mistake. The letter confirms everything.
Sure, it confirms that there's crazy people all over the world. Listen, Ma, if Japan won the war, what the hell are you doing here? Huh? What are you doing running a grocery store? It doesn't figure. It doesn't figure because you put your money on the wrong horse. I've had 2 years to think about what I've done, and you can't tell me that you still believe in that craziness.
We are here. We'll talk later when you're feeling better. I'm not the one saying the ship is coming. It's in the letter. Think more deeply and your doubts will disappear. You are my son, Ichiro.
There was a time when you used to smile a mother's smile and tell me stories about gallant and fierce warriors who protected their lords with blades of steel. Except I didn't slay any demons. They slayed me.
Oh, that Watanabe boy. So warui. He showed me all the pictures he had taken in Japan. He had many of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and I told him that he must be mistaken because Japan did not lose the war. He had been fooled by their lies. He yelled so much that his mother had to yell, tell him to be quiet. And I asked him if he had ever been in Japan before and could he prove that he was actually there. He said, look at the pictures. And I said that the army only told him he was in Japan and that it was too bad he believed in the propaganda. Then he got so mad his face went white and he said, how do you know anything? How do you know you are you?
How do you know you're you?
June has just come up from Los Angeles and is perhaps a little tired.
Sorry?
I try not to hate them, but I have no choice but to point them out to the authorities when the ships come.
Nah.
That's okay, Ichiro. Such an interesting story, Yamada-san. Ichiro, will you be going back to university?
I'll have to think about it.
He will go when the new term begins. With a college education, one can go so far in Japan.
Bobby always wanted to go to university and study medicine. He would have made a fine doctor. Always studying and reasoning. Isn't that so, Ichiro?
Sure, Bob was very, very studious. Where is Bob?
Mr. Komasaka.
You are his buddy, right?
That's right.
Please, as a favor to us all, will you explain it again for Ichiro?
Gosh, I don't know.
Please.
Well, okay. Well, the way it happened, Bobby and I, we had just gotten back to the rest area. Everyone was feeling good because there was a lot of talk about the Germans surrendering. All the fellows were cleaning their equipment. We'd been up in the lines for a long time, and everything was pretty well messed up. When you're getting shot at, you don't worry about how crummy your things got, but the minute you pull back, they gotta have inspection. So we were cleaning things up. Bobby was sitting beside me, and he was talking about how he was going to medical school to become a doctor.
Oh. Go on, Jun.
Bobby was like that. Me and the other guys, all we talked about was drinking and girls and stuff like that, because it's important to talk about those things when you make it back from the front on your own power. But Bobby, all he thought about was going to school. I was saying, yeah, yeah, and there was this pinging noise nearby. I cussed and I said, gee, that was damn close. I looked around and I saw Bobby's head slump between his knees. I thought he was fooling around and I tapped him on the arm. And he slumped over and I saw the dark spot on his head where the bullet had gone through. And that was it. Ping, and he's dead. It doesn't figure, but that's how it happened.
Ma! I'm so sorry.
You don't have to say anything, Ichiro. I'm sorry for you.
She's just... just...
Try to understand her, Ichiro. Just try.
Ping, and he's dead. It doesn't figure, but that's how it happened.
Hey!
Ichiro?
I thought you were in bed, Pa.
Waiting for you. Your first night home. I want to put you in bed.
Sure, sure. I know how it is.
Drink. You have to drink a little to be a man, you know?
Sure, Pa. Oh, God. How can you drink this stuff?
Only the first one or two is bad. After that, it gets easier.
You drink all this?
Yes, tonight.
That's quite a bit.
Yes, but I finish.
What are you celebrating?
Life.
What's wrong, Pa?
Nothing is wrong, Ichiro. I celebrate you. You're home and I am happy.
Things pretty rough?
No. We don't get rich, but we make enough.
What do you do with yourself?
Do.
Many people think Japan won the war.
No.
What do you think?
No.
Why?
I read. I hear. I see.
Why don't you tell Ma?
Your mama is sick, Ichiro. See, all these letters, they're from Japan. Brothers and sisters and cousins and nephews and people I hardly remember. Letters from your mama's family. They all beg for sugar and money and clothes and rice, tobacco and candy, anything. I read these letters and I drink and I cry because I drink some more because people are so suffering so horribly and there's nothing I can do.
Why don't you just send them some stuff?
Oh, Mama won't let me.
Oh, come on, Pa.
She says these letters are not from Japan. They're propaganda. She won't let me send money or food because it's all a trick. I can't tell her she's wrong.
I'm going to sleep, Pa.
Ichiro.
Yeah?
I'm sorry you went to prison.
Forget it. Just forget it.
So far, over 60 Japanese-American men have refused to report for induction into the armed forces of the United States. By their action, these young men have injured the cause of loyal Japanese-Americans everywhere.
Indictment for violation of Section 11 of the Selective Training and Service Act of 1940.
Disloyal Japs on trial.
The court, under the authority delegated, finds the defendant guilty as charged in the indictments.
Where are they moving me? Can you tell me? Where am I going now?
What is it, Ichiro?
Nothing.
You're not ill?
No, no.
Not sick for sure?
Oh, damn it. I'm fine, Pa. I'm fine.
I cook breakfast for you anyway.
Good morning, Ichiro. Did you sleep well?
Yeah, I feel like singing.
I did not tell you about Kumasaka-san's boy because it was not important. Do you understand?
No, I don't understand, but it doesn't matter.
The Germans did not kill Kumasaka-san's boy.
Of course not. It was an accident.
Germans, Americans, accident. Those things are not important. It was not the boy, but the mother who is to blame, and now they are both dead.
Bob is dead.
No, the mother is dead because she did not conduct herself as a Japanese, and no longer being Japanese, she is dead.
And you, Ma? What about you and Pa?
We are Japanese.
And me?
You are my Japanese son.
And that makes everything all right, does it? That makes it all right that Bob's dead and that the war was fought and hundreds of thousands killed and maimed and that I was 2 years in prison?
Yes.
What happens if I decide I'm not Japanese after all, that I'm American?
I will die because you will have turned your back on us.
You're crazy.
That is what they all say. I see it in their faces and I feel it on their lips. They do not mean it. They say it because they are frightened of me and because they envy my strength, which is the strength of Japan.
Stop it, Ma!
Ichiro!
I've got to get out of here. I'm going crazy. Pa, where's Freddy, Akimoto-san's boy? Where does he live?
He moved back to 19th.
I gotta talk to him.
Here, Ichiro.
It's a lot of money, Pa. I won't need that.
Take. Go to a movie with Freddy. Eat someplace nice. Have a good time.
Okay. Thanks, Pa.
The journey to the sea was long. And as he walked along the road, he came upon a spotted dog who growled at him at first. Momotaro gave him one of his kibidango and told the dog he was going to fight the demons on Oni Island. The dog told him he wanted to go along too, to fight the demons. So the two of them traveled on together.
What do you want?
I'm looking for Freddy Akimoto. He lives here, doesn't he?
Freddy always sleeps late. You can pound until he hears you, or you're welcome to sit in my place and wait. Freddy's a good friend of mine.
Thanks just the same, but I'm kind of anxious to see him.
Tell Freddy I have breakfast for him. Why don't you come with him?
I'll tell him.
Who is it, for Christ's sake? Who is it?
Freddy, it's Ichi.
Ichi boy, you got out. They let you out. About time, I say. About time. What time is it?
10 o'clock or thereabouts.
No wonder I'm sleepy. How you been, huh?
I just got home yesterday. What about you? Been out a while, huh?
They just kept me in Thule Lake as long as they could, but when they couldn't trade us to Japan, they had to let us out.
What?
Yeah. You should have been like me. Said no from the very beginning, instead of waiting for them to draft you. They put a bunch of us in Thule Lake, and once the war is over, they had to let us go.
Rub it in, why don't you?
Heck, you know I'm kidding. Actually, maybe we all should have done what you did. Said, yes, we're loyal, but heck no, we're not going to fight until you let our families out of hell, right?
I don't know anymore.
Ichi, I've been worried about you. Was it rough? Ah, no, it's out. You got some?
I'm done with all that. What I really want to know is, how's it going on out here?
It's all crap. That's how it's going. That's what I've been telling them. I got my life to live and they got theirs. They try to tell me something, I tell them shit. I did what I did. I'm proud of what I did. And I don't go trumpeting about it in their face, and I don't expect them to pat me on the back about it either.
You haven't had no trouble?
Trouble? What for? You and me, we made our choice and suddenly we ain't so popular with our old friends. So what? Doesn't mean we gotta stop living.
What have you been doing?
Living? I've been having a good time. I thought about catching up the entire time I was rotting away in those places, and God damn it, I'm getting laid. I'm having fun. I'm catching up.
What happens after you catch up?
Maybe I won't.
So what happens if you don't?
Stop moralizing, Ichi. I'm doing all right. Don't make me out to be as miserable as you are.
I just thought you, of all people, would know.
I do know. You know what I did the first week? I sat on my fanny the whole week, thinking, and I came to a conclusion. I've got no brains in my fanny, so I got off my fanny, and I went next door to 2A, and I stayed on her fanny until her old man come home, if you know what I'm saying.
Hey, Freddy! I've got something hot and round for ya!
Whew! Smells good! Thanks, baby! Funny, ain't it? I'm the guy who used to be so damn particular about dames. She ain't nothing but a fat pig, but now I can't get enough of it. I can't get enough of her. Bet she gave you a once over.
How long do you expect to get away with it?
Oh, can it? I know what you're thinking. And I don't give a damn. And in the meanwhile, I got something to hang on to. Sure. You can laugh now. It's funny as hell, huh? I'll lay 2 bits. You wish that you had an anchor like her before the week's out. You can get pretty lonely when all of a sudden you've turned invisible to the guys who grew up with. All she wants is me, the way I am, no questions. And she likes me, no matter what anyone else says.
Sure. I see your point.
I don't think you do. Me? I've been out and around. I seen Kaz one day. Used to shoot Megs together. That's how long I've known him. He goes to med school on GI. He was glad as hell to see me. Stuck his hand out. Then he remembered who I was and he said something about being in a hurry and took off. That's how it is. Everybody wants to blame us for what happened. Nobody wants to blame Roosevelt.
Yeah, like Eto.
That jerk. What'd he do, spit on you?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Ugh. We got troubles, but that stupid crud's got more than us. And he ain't even got the sense to know it. 6 months he was in the army. 6 lousy months, and he gets wangled a medical discharge. And now he pretends to be a hero. You ever try that on me, I'll stick a knife in him.
Maybe he's got a right to his opinion.
Nobody's got the right to spit on you.
Keep him. I'll get some on the way home.
You ain't going yet, are you? You just came.
I'll see you again, Freddy. I want to look around by myself. You know how it is. Maybe catch a bus and ride all over town. I feel like it.
Sure, sure. Buzz me on the phone. I'm in the book. We guys get together every Friday for poker. We can sure use a 6 hand.
What guys?
Guys. Like you and me. Guys from Tule Lake. Some you know from Minidoka, some you don't. You think you got it bad. There's even a guy who renounced his citizenship. They were going to send the poor SOB back, but they couldn't work out a deal. Turns out Japan didn't want him either. Ain't that nuts?
Yeah.
So, Friday poker?
Give me a little time, Freddy. I just need a little time to straighten out.
You've been stewing about it for 2 years. How much time you need? Wise up, Ichi. We did the right thing. Hey, Ichi, wise up.
Momotaro and a spotted dog kept on walking until they met a monkey. The monkey screamed at the dog, but Momotaro told him about their journey to Oni Island, and the monkey decided to join them on their march to the sea.
Wise up.
Ichiro bumps into Kenji, a one-legged young man with a prosthetic leg and a cane.
Hey, wise up.
Sorry, I didn't see,
Hey, Ichi. Ichi Yamada.
Kenji Kano.
Yeah. Oh, what's left of me, at least.
What happened? How you been?
I've been better. You headed back to the university?
I was thinking about it, but it's not the same. Or maybe I'm not the same.
Join the club. So what are your plans?
I haven't got any.
We've got something in common then.
Why?
I haven't got any either.
They walk towards Kenji's car.
Wow. New?
Yeah. Got it for being a good patient. Get in. He gave me a medal too. A silver star. Medal, car, pension, also packing a rifle.
Better than a kick in the pants. Man, football star, track star, now hero.
Yeah, you forgot one hell of a dancer too.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Some guys just have all the luck, huh?
I'm sorry, Kenji.
No, don't be. I'm just glad to see you.
Maybe you shouldn't be.
Why not?
I wasn't in the army, Ken. I was in jail. I was a draft resister. Want me to get out?
Why'd you do it?
You want to know something funny?
Try me.
I thought I knew. And it might have made sense to me at the time, but after a while, whatever was in my head went straight into my gut.
Roll down your window.
What?
Turned out to be a pretty nice day, huh?
You're nuts.
I should beat you to death with my cane, but I won't.
What?
You want me to cut off your conscience like they cut off my leg?
I can't hear you. What?
They cut off my leg.
I'm sorry.
I was lucky. Doctors didn't have to go to work too hard at cutting my leg off because that machine gun had done a pretty good job. They were pretty proud about saving my knee. Makes things easier with a sound knee, you know?
I don't know what to say.
They gave me a fake leg, and it worked out pretty well. Only after a while, it started to hurt. And I went back into the hospital, and it turned out that there's something rotten in my leg. It's eating it away. So they cut off a little more, gave me a new leg. It wasn't long before I was back in. They whacked off another chunk. This time, they took off more than they had to, just to make sure that they got all the rottenness. I was 5 months ago. A couple of days ago, I noticed the pain's coming back.
Bad?
Bad enough.
You'll get well. They got ways nowadays.
I know a way to get well for a little while.
Kenji and Ichiro walk into the Club Oriental.
I like it here. I could just live here, working up to a nice, lazy feeling, just hoisting up my arm every once in a while. It's better than morphine.
Sounds good.
Yeah, but not for you.
Why not?
You're not dying.
Sometimes I wish I were.
No, don't say that. You can't say that, not to me.
Sorry.
I'm just saying don't blame yourself.
Then who's to blame?
Doesn't matter. Blame the world, blame the war, blame the dummies who brought all the lies, but don't blame yourself.
I remember the first time I laid a girl. She was a redhead in my history class.
Redhead? You mean you laid Velma Thorson?
I guess actually she laid me. I was scared, but I was more scared after it was done. Worried about it for weeks. Worried about the fact that her parents would find out. Worried that she'd get pregnant. I thought I had troubles then.
Sounds like a pretty good deal to me.
When I was in prison, believe me, I thought about Velma a lot.
Prison. That's rough.
Rougher than getting shot at?
No. I don't know. Who would know?
For Christ's sake, if it ain't Peg Leg.
Eto.
Come on, sit with us. I'll fix you up.
I'm with a friend.
God damn it. Brand new suit damn near got it all cruddy.
Cut it out, Eto.
Those damn no-no boys don't look so good without the striped uniform, do they?
Go on, Eto. Your girlfriend's waiting.
What's with you, Gimpy? Nuts or something? Sitting with this guy?
Go on back to your girl.
Sure, sure. Hey, Mr. War Hero. Any friend of yours? It's a friend of yours.
Let's get out of here.
No!
He's a dumb lug and he doesn't know what he's saying.
Oh, he knows what he's saying and he means it. They all mean it. I can see it in their faces.
And then you're looking too hard.
I feel it.
And then you're feeling too much.
Sons of bitches. That's what they all are. Dirty, no good sons of bitches.
You know what? I agree. Hey, slow down.
You are too.
Sure. Yeah, that's right. The world's full of us.
Everybody except me. I'm not even a son of a bitch. I'm nothing. I'm no one. I'm I'm a joke. I'm a mistake.
Oh, you're not. You're just drunk.
I'm just getting started. I'm gonna get stinko so I can just be a son of a bitch too.
You don't want to be a son of a bitch.
I do.
No, you don't.
Henji, you're okay. You've already done plenty for me, and you don't have to. You're a goddamn hero, okay? So I'll tell you what. I'm gonna do something for you. You go over there, sit with your friend, the monkey in the suit, and I'll go out the door and forget I ever saw you. Slate's clean. Your hands are clean. You're clean. Fair enough.
Hey.
Hey is for horses. I'm your brother.
I want to talk to you, brother.
Talk then.
Come outside.
I like it here.
I'll go. I have to hit the John anyway.
No, stay. Piss on the floor if you got to. This ought to be good. My brother's finally got something to say to me. And I want you, my friend, to hear it. Well, Taro, what is it? What do you want to say to me?
Come outside and I'll tell you.
Oh, for Christ's sake, don't make me do that.
Come on, big brother. Ain't you been sitting long enough?
Good point.
I'll come with you.
Nope, this is a family powwow. Keep my glass warm and I'll be right back. Hey! Hey, slow down! Where in the hell are you going?
Hey, looky here, Taro. You've got a traitor following you.
I thought I smelled something yellow.
You mean it's scared?
Too scared to fight, that's for sure.
You think it'd fight back if I gave it a kick?
Eto kicks Ichido, knocking him down.
Look out. He looks like he might bite.
Just like a dog.
Except dogs don't wear pants.
Right. We can't let it run around with pants on. People will think it's human.
Eto snaps open a knife.
All right, knock it off.
This is none of your business.
Kenji swings his cane, knocking the knife free.
Hey, Pegleg, we're on your side.
Kenji swings his cane, hitting Eto.
You are not on my side!
And Taro, you are not my brother.
You got that right. I'm not your brother.
Well, I'm glad he's not your brother, because that guy's a son of a bitch. Come on. To make me carry you, I don't have the balance.
Where the hell are we going?
We're gonna go meet a friend.
Now? What time is it?
Doesn't matter. You need some help.
Yeah, well, I'm not exactly sober.
She won't mind.
She?
She's a friend of mine. She can help you. And you know what? I think you can help her.
And then Momotaro and his new friends continued their journey, and they came across a beautiful pheasant. When Momotaro told the pheasant what they were doing, she wanted to go with them to Oni Island too. The animals snarled and bickered until Momotaro told them they must put aside their differences if they were going to fight the demons.
You left your car running. You gonna make a quick getaway?
I've got a friend inside sleeping it off. It's cold out there.
To what do I owe the pleasure of this late night visit?
You heard from anyone lately?
My dad wrote.
And how is he?
Sick. Sick of Japan, sick of the rotten food, and sick of being stuck there.
No hope of coming back?
No.
Nothing from Ralph?
Ralph's not the writing kind, you know that.
You still love the guy.
Why do you always ask?
If I were you and my husband signed up for another hitch in Germany without coming home or asking me, I'd stop loving him. I'd divorce him.
You know, you say that every time you come out here, and every time you say it, I say, it's none of your business.
You're right. It's not.
So when are you going to stop asking?
Sorry. It's just getting to be a habit.
You want some coffee?
Sure. Could you make some for my friend? Hey, Ichiro. Come in. Make yourself comfortable.
Ichiro sits down at the piano.
I'm sorry. I thought you were, you look just like, you know, you remind me of someone sitting there like that.
Hey, you're right. He does look like Ralph. Emmy, this is Ichiro. Ichiro, Emmy.
Hi.
Can you play chopsticks?
Let's see.
Emmy joins him.
Yeah, not bad.
I try.
Hey, where'd you learn how to play?
I learned from an old German guy named Burke. He made music with the same hands he used to choke his wife to death. He taught me in prison.
You were in prison?
Yeah, murder.
Well, what?
He's kidding.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Sorry. It was because of the war.
Oh, well, you can say that about a lot of things.
It was the draft. I didn't go.
Oh, sorry. Really sorry.
Don't be. I'm sorry enough for two.
Let me get the coffee.
Where are we?
Out in the country, away from it all. You'll see what it's like in the morning. We can sleep here. Emmy doesn't mind.
All right, enjoy your coffee, boys. It's awful late. I'm going to bed.
I'll sack out here.
You'll both sack out there.
What's going on?
Why do you ask?
Where are we supposed to sleep?
Well, I've got this couch.
What about me?
You're sleeping in the bedroom.
Which one?
There's only one. Listen, She needs you. She waited 4 years for Ralph to come back, and we were in the same outfit, and Ralph signed up for another hitch. He asked me to look her up and tell her that he wasn't coming back for a while. Would you wait?
Nuts! I'll sack out there.
What? Are you crazy? You've been in jail too long. Besides, there's no room.
Then I'll sack out in the car.
No, don't sleep in the car, Chiro. You'll freeze out there.
Nice house.
Thanks.
You live here alone?
Yes. My mom died in 39, and my dad's in Japan. He got repatriated, and now he's stuck there. Crazy, huh?
My ma thinks that Japan won the war.
Yeah, so do my dad. Guess he doesn't anymore.
What makes them that way?
They're Japanese.
Is that why I did what I did?
They're no more Japanese than I am. I meant, they're crazy.
Maybe I was crazy.
Maybe we're all crazy.
Do you still think I'm crazy?
I don't know.
Why don't you know? Can't you tell?
Maybe you just made a mistake.
Maybe the government just made a mistake.
Maybe they did.
Pretty bad mistake.
Listen, my dad was a veteran in the First World War, and when they put him in camp, he swore that if they were going to treat him like the enemy, then he would act like one. He ended up in Tule Lake and became a leader in the strikes and the riots. They sent him back to Japan, and now he's stuck there. My husband, Ralph, joined the army, and he won't come back because of my father. Why? My dad made a mistake. Why is it that Ralph has to punish himself for my father's mistake?
I don't know. Seems like you're the one he's punishing.
A lot of people got punished. Sometimes we get a hopeless feeling, but a hopeless feeling doesn't mean that there's no hope.
Are you saying there is?
There has to be.
Why?
Because we're still alive. I mean, tell me, what are we supposed to do with our lives? What do you propose you do with your life? Drown yourself in bitterness? Is your life over? You're young and alive and supposedly smart. Why don't you act smart?
What am I supposed to do?
Anything. It doesn't matter what you do. This country made a mistake when they doubted you, but they let you go. Why can't you get it through your head? You're free now.
The way you say that, it seems to make sense, but I don't know how. I was in prison. Hell, you were in prison.
No, I wasn't.
You were in camp. You want to know something funny? It was warmer in prison than it was in camp.
It's over. Can't you let it be over? I mean, you know how to forgive. I know you do.
I don't. I can't.
You can. I know you can.
He kisses her.
You can.
End of Act One.
Forgetful of a promise of love, you're sharing another's charm.
With a sad lament, my dreams have faded like a broken melody.
While the gods of love look down and laugh at what romantic fools we mortals be.
Ma and Ichido in a mini doka barrack.
We are prisoners, Ichiro. Prisoners in the middle of nowhere.
If they draft us, that's if. The guys say we'd fight in Europe.
No, I will not allow it. They have taken everything from us and put us in this desert. We worked our entire lives for that little store, and they have taken everything away from us. And now, they want you, our firstborn son? No!
What would you have me do?
This is not your country!
Well, that's what it says on my birth certificate.
So why are you here, locked up here in the desert with us? Why is an American in an internment camp, huh? Because you're not American. You are Japanese. If you were American, you wouldn't be behind barbed wire with the rest of us, the Japanese. To them, we are the enemy. You are the enemy.
You can't make me do anything.
You are my son, my flesh, my blood. Would you turn your back on me? On your papa? On everyone? Everyone who came before you, everyone who struggled and fought to live so that someday you would be born? For a country who hates you? You would do that?
I see it now, but I couldn't see it then. Everything was so crazy in camp. Then when she snapped, I couldn't tell. How can you tell when it's all nuts anyway? But I came back here and she's flipped, stripped to gears.
Worse than before?
100 times.
What can you do?
Hell, maybe I'll stay in Portland. Start fresh.
Aren't you worried about her?
I'm more worried about you.
We'll get to Portland soon enough. Not too many cars on the road this time of night.
What's your ma like?
My ma? She's swell.
What makes her swell?
I don't know. She just is.
What about your pop?
I don't really remember him. Just, I remember this one time he had a bunch of friends over playing poker. The sound of poker chips, cigarettes. He laughed really loud one time. I guess he must have won big or something. That's all I remember about him.
At least you remember him winning.
Yeah, maybe that's why I have this feeling things were pretty good. We were getting ahead, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And after he died, seems like it just took a while for my ma to get back us, to get back to where we used to be.
Then the war.
Then the war.
Damn, lousy bastards.
Slow down. When he pulls ahead, you switch places with me.
What do you think you were doing?
45, maybe 50.
70. You were doing 70, boy. See that sign?
Sure.
Read what it says.
20 miles per hour, street patrolled.
Well?
We're guilty. Put us in jail.
Funny. You're funny. Tell you what, next court won't be until day after tomorrow now. You don't want to come all the way back here and get fined $50. That's what it's going to be, you know? So you might want to just walk down over to my car and drop $10 in the seat. Simple.
Just give me the ticket. I'll show up for court.
All right, smart guy, let me have your license.
Son of a bitch. He's got us down for 80, drunk driving, and attempting to bribe.
He's gonna have to go a long way to catch up with this Jap.
Portland again?
It'll be okay, Mom. It'll be okay. They might not even have to operate. Hey, I almost forgot. I brought you a little something special. I remember you told me a story about this once.
All I did was feed and clothe you and spank you once in a while, and suddenly you're all grown up.
Are you happy, Ma?
Yes, Kenji, I'm happy. I'm happy you brought me such a naughty present.
Mom, it's okay. I'm gonna be all right.
I'll go with you.
No, no. I've got a friend to share the drive with. You just stay here and you take care of business, okay?
Gee, what if I forbid you to join the army? Would you have stayed behind?
Mama, I would have gone anyway.
A mother is supposed to protect her children.
But I'm not a child.
You are to me.
Look, so what? My leg hurts. So what? I'm lucky. I have you. And that's all that matters, right?
I'll come with you.
Stay here. I'll be back in a week or so.
You promise?
I got it all figured out. Economics. That's what. I hear this guy with the stars, the general who cleaned the Japs off the coast, got $1 million for the job. All this bull about us being security risks and saboteurs and Shinto freaks, that's for the birds and the dumbheads. The only way it figures is the money angle. How much they give you, Mr. Judge? Cut me in. Give me a cut and I'll go fight your war. Come on, cut me in.
Ken?
Hey, Michio. How do you like Portland? That well, huh?
All cares. What about you? What the doctors say?
I don't know why I didn't go to med school. I told you the diagnosis before the doc could tell me.
Do they tell you for sure?
They know it, and I know it, and they know I know it. Hey, why don't you sit down? You're making me nervous.
I'm not supposed to be here. Visiting hours are over, but I snuck in and came up anyway.
Not with him. Stay. Sit down. Relax.
Quiet here.
It's good for thinking. Listen. Take the Oldsmobile back to Seattle today.
I think I'm gonna stick around here for a bit, Kenji.
Go back to Seattle, Ichi. You don't understand why people are so mad. You weren't here when we all started moving back to the coast. There was a lot of busted windows, name calling, dirty words on houses. Those guys who make it tough on you got this idea that maybe you're to blame. They risk their lives for the people who don't want them in their neighborhoods. They're mad, and they think guys like you were to blame.
Those guys I'll never forget.
No, I did.
What good is that if you're just gonna...
Do me a favor. You go back until they have enough sense to leave you alone. You go back to Emmy. She needs your help. You two can help each other.
I think you're forgetting she's already got a husband.
I'm gonna write to Ralph. Tell him how you two are hitting it off.
Why? That's not true.
Yeah, but what he's doing isn't right. They should be together or they should split up. If I tell him about how you and her are hot for each other, it might make him mad enough to come back. And if it doesn't...
Maybe I'm not so useless after all.
Tell her I was thinking about her, okay?
Sure.
And have a drink for me? Drink to whatever it is I'm headed. And don't let there be any Japs or Chinks or Kikes or Pollocks or Frenchies.
Frenchies?
You know what I mean. People. Christ.
Yeah. Okay.
And tell my mom that I was fine when you saw me.
I will.
Go home, you two. Okay?
Okay, Kenji. Well.
Bye.
Bye.
Ichiro.
What?
You got to love the world the way you used to. You're taking me out dancing. That's the way it ought to be. There's a place for you and Emmy out there in the hustle of things. If you'll just let it be that way.
I'll think about it.
Oh. Oh. Ah. Ah. Nurse. Nurse. Hey, nurse. Do you have a minute? I gotta tell you something, okay? See, there was this German I killed. He wasn't the only one I killed, but I remember this one guy. He was up on the roof of the barn when I shot him. Killed him. And I see him rolling down the roof. I see him all the time. I see him all the time. And that's why I want this other place I'm going to have only people, because if I'm a Jap and this guy's still a German, I might have to shoot him again. And I don't want to have to do that, okay? But then again, maybe dying is it. It's the finish. The end. Nothing. I'd like that too.
And then the four friends paddled across the sea towards Onigashima to do battle against the demons.
Hello, Emmy.
I saw the Oldsmobile. I thought.
I'm sorry.
He's not coming back.
I don't think so. He told me to tell you that he's thinking about you.
I'll make you something to eat.
Wait, can I ask you something? Do you love Kenji?
In a way. Maybe too much. Or not enough. Apparently, not enough.
Any other time I wouldn't understand that, but for some reason, right now, I do.
What will you do now?
I don't know. I was thinking of staying in Portland, but I changed my mind.
Why?
Something told me I should come back.
So what will you do here?
I don't know, but I have to go. I like you a lot. I like you a lot. And if I keep seeing you, I'll fall in love with you. And that can't happen because Ralph's going to come back.
He won't.
Kenji's writing to him. He's got something in mind that'll jolt Ralph into realizing what he's doing. He'll be back.
He kisses her.
Mrs. Kano?
Oh. It's you.
Hello, Mrs. Kano. I'm Kenji's friend, Ichiro. I brought his car back.
I know who you are, Ichiro Yamada. Would you like to come in?
No. I should get on home.
Can I ask you, when did you last see him?
Just last night.
How was he? Was he still alert?
Of course. He'll be fine another week, 10 days.
Don't lie to me, Ichiro. Kenji is dead. They called me this afternoon. Kenji deserved to live. He deserved to be happy.
I should go.
Kenji deserved to live.
I know.
I don't want to hear it anymore.
Just wait, Taro. Mama don't understand. So you must understand for her. Try. Wait until graduation. Then if she still says no, you go. Anyway, finish high school.
What's going on?
Birthday party. You gonna sing for me too, brother?
I don't think so.
Then why don't you get your buddies from the pen and do it right? You can sing me happy birthday in Japanese, except I wouldn't go for that.
How can you hate me so much?
How?
Ichiro. Taro is 18 today. He tell Mama and me, I'm 18 and I'm going into the army.
Are you?
You want me to send you a letter? It's none of your business.
What about Ma?
What about her? And what about you?
Damn it, Taro, give it time.
I gave it time. I had plenty of time to think about it when you were in prison. And here's what I think. We were born here. We play ball here. We listen to music here. We get married here. We're going to have kids here. We owe this country something for that. Let Ma believe what she believes. Let Pa go along with it. And if he wants, but me, I'm an American. And I'm gonna fight like an American. You and your pals, you had your chance. And what did you prove? That they were right not to trust you.
Taro! Where have you been?
I took Kenji to the hospital.
How is he?
He died.
You're better off without such a friend.
How can you say that?
He brought shame to his mother and grief to himself.
Ma? He was the best friend I got, and now he's gone.
His death is his punishment.
Ma, he was my friend. What's wrong with you? When did you get so mean? When did you get so crazy?
You have been listening to them. The weak ones. The ones who call me names, who hate me, who fear me because of my strength.
Balls, 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 balls. They call you crazy because you are crazy. Look at me. I'm your mirror. I'm my mother's son. I'm as crazy as you are. I must have been crazy before, and now I know why. Look at me! See how crazy you are. Look at me!
Ichiro! Stop it! Stop it!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Pa.
Yeah, Ichiro. I'm sorry, too.
Yeah, I lost my head, Pa.
Yeah, I know. I know. Mama, come in here.
We need more nickels.
I have a letter from your sister. It's time you read it.
I have to watch the store.
Sit down, Mama.
I have to watch the store.
I say sit down.
When will you learn? Those letters are lies.
This one is from your sister who calls you Kim-chan.
I won't read it.
I will read it. Many, many pardons, dear Kim-chan, for not having written to you long before this, but I did not want to write of unpleasant things, and all has been unpleasant since the disastrous outcome of the war. I have tried to remain proud, but it is not an easy thing to do when one's children are always cold and hungry. For myself, I ask nothing, but for the children, if it is possible, a little sugar, or the meat which you have in cans, or the white powder, which can be made into milk. I'm begging, but that is all I can do. That's the way things are. Forgive me, Kim-chan.
I won't listen.
One more place I will read. Remember the river and how you almost drowned that day? We vowed never to tell anyone, and I mention it only now because I'm desperate. And I hope that you will remember how close we were, my little sister.
Oh, they're so clever. So clever. How could they know? How?
I hurt her, Ichiro.
It's okay, Pa.
She's just sitting there. The letter, Mama. Maybe you're right. Who knows what they might do to make you think?
Can it, Pa? It'll be all right. She'll live.
You are young, Ichiro. Old minds are not so easily changed.
I went to jail for you and Ma, and I lived.
You are young, Ichiro. It's easier for you.
Easier? Do you understand what I did for you?
Yeah, I do. You did your duty.
It wasn't my duty. I did it for you, for Ma, and for everyone else who couldn't figure out that this was wrong. What they did to us was wrong. You don't even understand why I did it. You don't understand me or Taro and why he had to join the goddamn army, but you understand Mama's insanity? A goddamn fool! That's what you are, Papa. A goddamn fool.
She's my wife, Ichiro. One day, you will understand.
I gotta go.
Go. I'll take care of Mama.
Yeah, okay. You do that.
Poor Mama.
Freddy gets into a car, wielding a knife.
What the hell?
Hey, take it easy. It's just me.
What the hell?
Okay, just take off. Go. Goddamn, Freddy, what's the hurry?
You told me to take off, so I did.
I didn't mean you had to drive like a crazy man. Slow down.
Make up your mind, for Christ's sake. You can do better, you drive.
What's eating you?
Nothing. Just don't ever do that again.
Do what?
Scare me like that. You do that again, I'll shove this right between your balls.
Who did you think I was?
One of them guys.
What guys?
Hey, where are we going?
We're going to find out why you're so jumpy.
I cut Eto.
What?
He asked for it. He came at me at the bar, just digging at me. I told him beat him, and he wouldn't go. The guys were all laughing, and he said shit like me wasn't worth spitting on, so I stabbed him right in the ass.
What?
Yeah. When I went for him, someone pulled him off the stool and swung him around, and somehow my knife got him right in the ass.
What happened after that?
The guys who run the place kicked us out, and on my way back, some of Edo's guys tried to run me down. Didn't miss me by much more than an inch, bunch of bastards. They better keep out of my way.
You're nuts.
Nah, he won't do nothing.
Well, what if he does?
Who gives a damn?
Is this what you call living it up?
Well, can it? I didn't ask for you to give me no lecture. I get a belly full of that at home from 2A. Come on, let's go do something. Let's go get a drink at the club.
Isn't that where you cut Eto? You gotta be 86th.
Not for stabbing a guy in the ass. Come on, you and me, we can take him.
What the hell's the matter with you?
Look, I'm tired of running, aren't you? Aren't you tired of acting like anyone's got a right to tell you what to do? Or having a belly full of that?
I'm just sick of the trouble.
Me too, brother. Me too. Let's stop acting like we deserve it.
Paul falls hard against the pavement.
Okay. Everything okay. Just fall. Son of a bitch. Oh. Good, mama. A bath is good. Bath.
Ichiro and Freddy walk into the Club Oriental.
To Kenji.
Who's that? Some guy in stir?
He's a friend of mine. Asked me how to have a drink for him.
To him? Your friend? Listen, Ichi, I've been thinking. I've got to get out of here. Make a fresh start. I've been moping on you around. I've been on you about moping around and feeling lousy about yourself, but I've been lying to myself, trying to make believe that I don't give a damn what other people think. I still think I'm better off than you.
That's not saying much.
No. It's not. But you know what? I can't hide out with 2A all day and stab every guy who hates me in the ass. I'm going to go someplace where I don't have to drink with guys like Eto breathing down my neck.
I thought you were proud of what you did.
I am, but hell, I already made my stand. These guys will punish you guys like you and me for the rest of our lives.
So what? You gonna let them drive you out?
Not drive me out, crap. Everyone wants a new start, and that's all I want myself.
Just let me know before you take off.
You and 2A.
You ever think about life?
Ma? Ma? Oh my God! Oh God! Ma! Pa! Pa! Are you all right?
Mama's sick. Papa's sick.
Ma's dead, Papa. Do you hear me? She killed herself.
Mama's sick.
God damn you, Pa! I'm telling you, Ma's dead!
Tell Tara to come home.
There was a time when I was your son. I was that boy, the peach. You were the old woman, and we were Japanese, with Japanese feelings and Japanese pride and Japanese thoughts, because it was all right to be Japanese even when we lived in America. I was not strong enough to fight you, and I was not strong enough to fight the anger, which made the half of me that was you bigger than the half of me that was American. And the whole of me that I could not see or feel. Now the half of me, which is you, is no longer here. And the half of me that remains American is only American by law. Now, I'm not your son, and I'm not Japanese, but then, what am I? For me, you have been dead a long time. Maybe you died when I was in prison, or maybe you died when I came home. I've had so much time to feel sorry for myself, but now I feel sorry for you. Not sorry that you're dead, but sorry for the happiness that you never know. So now you're free. You are free. And what am I? Pa? That incense is making me sick.
Yeah, Ichiro. But not much more. We're almost finished.
What's next? I think I had enough.
We go to the funeral parlor for another service, then cremation, and then we go eat Chinese food.
Eat?
Yes, it's custom. We feed the people who came.
Pa, I can't.
Ichiro, stop. Where are you going?
Emmy.
I'm sorry, I was late. I was in the back, but where are you going?
I don't know. I just can't take it anymore.
It's okay, Chira. I know. Let's just sit down for a minute.
You hear about Kenji?
Yes.
Oh, Emmy's. When do you think it's gonna stop? I thought when I got out, it'd all be over, but when's it gonna stop?
Soon. I'm getting a divorce from Ralph.
Does he know?
He's the one who asked for it.
I guess Kenji never got around to writing that letter.
Oh, not that it would have done any good.
Ralph's an idiot.
Don't.
Sorry. It'll be nice for the fellas to have you back in circulation, at least.
I have been lonely a long time, Ichiro. And I didn't realize how lonely until you stopped by to tell me about Kenji, and it sounded like you weren't gonna come by anymore, and it made me think like I'm going crazy.
Listen, Emmy, I'm no good for you. No good for anybody.
Why? Why do you say that?
It's true. That's why.
I had these crazy thoughts, like you might come by and take me out dancing or something.
Is that so?
Crazy, huh?
Yeah, crazy. And we're not crazy, are we?
What?
I ran out of my own mother's funeral. Isn't that a little crazy?
Little.
On the other hand, what's more right than two people going out dancing because they feel like it?
Maybe we'll feel more like it another time.
Another time?
Why not?
Ichi.
So, you're going.
Yeah. Friend of a friend. A guy like you, in fact. Got a job lined up for me down in LA.
What about living it up?
Maybe I finally got caught up.
You've been asking for this, you little shit.
Let me go, you stupid bastard.
Hey, what the hell? Let him go, Eto.
Anybody wants to butt in, I'll cut his balls off.
Put the knife down.
Goddamn cowards.
Ichiro punches Eto, who falls, carrying Freddy with him. Freddy pulls out his knife, Eto knocks him down, and falls onto Freddy's knife.
Freddy, get out of here. Freddy, get out of here.
Come look me up one of these days, will ya?
Hey, somebody, call an ambulance.
I ain't sorry. Not one bit. I hope he goes to hell. I hope... Oh, God. Mama!
And so Momotaro and his friends crossed the sea to Oni Island, which was surrounded by a high wall. The pheasant flew over the wall and saw how the gate was latched. She flew back and told the monkey, who climbed over the gate and unlocked it as Momotaro and the spotted dog rushed through to attack the demons. They were badly outnumbered, but the pheasant pecked the demons from above while the dog bit them from below. The monkey jumping high and low confused the Oni while Momotaro fought them head on. Until finally, after a long, hard-fought battle that felt like a lifetime, the demons surrendered. At last, Momotaro and his friends, who were once enemies, returned home victorious, knowing it was their friendship that won the day.
Pa ties up several large packages.
Japan?
Yeah, Ichiro. I send them tomorrow.
Sorry for all the trouble I caused, Pa.
I understand, Ichiro. I understand. What will happen to your friend?
I don't know. I guess it depends on whether or not they find him. What are you going to do now?
I fix up the store. Mama was saving for Japan. She went for free. So now, I fix up the store. You can stay here, take time.
Wanna know something funny, Pa? I dreamt you were in my room last night reading me a story.
Oh yeah, I used to read you stories sometimes.
You did? I thought it was Ma.
Sometimes it was Mama.
I don't know which is stranger, the idea of you reading me stories or Mama.
We were happy once.
Yeah, when you say it like that, I almost remember that.
You like her, you know?
No. How?
Restless.
What about you, Pa?
I was restless when I was young, and then I came to America, and that was enough for me.
I'm not restless anymore. Are you going out?
Yeah, dancing.
That's good, Ichiro. That's good.
Thanks, Pa. I'll pay you back one of these days.
Take time, Ichiro. Take time.
Ichiro and Ami dance slowly, close together.
What's so funny?
I don't know. I was enjoying this, you know, and then a funny thought came into my head.
What?
Nobody's looking twice at us.
They're busy.
Yeah, I know. They're living.
Right. They're living.
Maybe it's done. Maybe.
You can hold your head high. Maybe.
You can be proud of what you've done. Maybe because we were born here, we're going to have kids here. Maybe.
You can finally understand. Maybe.
We're just people. Maybe.
It doesn't figure, but that's how it is.
Bing.
And I'm alive.
He kisses Emmy. She kisses him. Fade to black. End of play. Thank you guys for coming and watching this reading of Nono Boy. I want to thank my cast, Regina, Brittany, Kevin, Momo, Stan, Sean, Dan, and Greg. Thank you guys so much.